Gavin, how are you feeling before we go into this? How are you feeling?
It's all right.
You.
Cooper, how are you feeling? Nice.
Reluctantly crouched at the starting line. Engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town.
Start blocks, baby. I run. 4-0.
4-0. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. He's going the distance.
That's a dub, baby. Dubs.
Oh, I didn't see you there. Welcome to Eztv 109, and welcome back from Thanksgiving break. Speaking of Thanksgiving, the Alt-Ed program held a Thanksgiving dinner. Let's see how it went.
Mr. Payton asked that our team revitalize an old tradition that happened at Frontier High School, and it was started about, I believe, 28 years ago. So since our program has gone from 8 to about 45 kids, he thought this would be a great time to do it. So he asked us if we would all be on board to do the community dinner. So I was like, okay, we're gonna do this, rah. So it really is an all alt-ed community project, and we're hoping it goes really, really well. And by Friday, I'm gonna be doing the happy Snoopy dance that it's over.
EHS Palms team went to regionals before Thanksgiving break, and now they're competing at state. Let's check that out.
The competition that we're heading to tomorrow is our league competition. It's at Vista Ridge High School, which is about an hour away, but we're really excited for it. It's our first competition of the season.
When you're out there, you just kind of black out.
I am feeling very nervous.
But a lot of these girls learn from the ground up.
For me, when a competition's coming up, I get in my head a lot. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from we really go eight count by eight count, making sure we have every single motion locked in. As the captain, I try to look out for the team a little bit more than just looking out for myself, especially with the stress that competitions do cause.
If we work hard now, we will work harder in the future, and that will get us further.
Marching Band killed it during their season and placed second in state.
Marching Band's a really intricate activity. There's playing, there's moving, there's choreography. Everybody plays a really pivotal role in the success of our overall show. We kind of have to break all of those concepts down, right? So when people come in summer camps and stuff, a lot of them have never marched before. And it's a specific technique that we teach them. So that they can play their best while also moving across the field. Marching band leadership is pretty intensive. In March, right before and right after spring break, they have to apply to be a marching band section leader or drum major, and I rely heavily on the leadership team for the marching band. So once they are appointed through a series of interviews and auditions, they are responsible essentially for making sure their section is ready to go in every aspect. So we have a brass captain, which was Drake Baker. We have a band captain, who is Junior Lizzie Kohlmeyer. We have a color guard captain, who is Amaya Tunstall. We have a woodwind captain, who is Aaron Zapfe. We have a drum major, who was Hannah Ertz. And then we have a percussion captain, who was Senior Jamie Seehusen.
My story with joining band is, it started in eighth grade, and I joined concert band just out of nowhere. It wasn't something I was ever considering, but I wanted to do something different. So I started in eighth grade at the middle school, and then I ended up coming here, and I had heard plenty of good things about the marching band. And I was enjoying my time in band, honestly. I was doing football as well, but band kind of just took over for me. It was a great time. I got into marching band, and yeah, it just took off. That year was COVID, so we didn't really get to do too much, but that just helped me build relationships with the other people in the band, and it ended up just becoming something that I started putting so much time to and that I really enjoyed doing throughout 4 years now.
Girls and boys basketball and wrestling has officially started, and they're gearing up for an amazing season.
Now that fall sports have come to a close, it's time to see how winter sports are shaping up.
I'm with Caleb Dunn, varsity point guard this year. Caleb, you're returning from injury. You missed the heart of your high school career. How excited are you for your return this year?
I'm pretty excited. I think it'll be a good year. You know, just excited to be back on the floor.
I am like beyond excited to just have like a positive group of girls together and just getting a program started for like the next year's going.
I mean, we've just been dreaming about playing varsity basketball for a long time all together, so we just got to put together this year, and I think it'll be good.
You are going to make mistakes in this game, but like, you just have to try and like keep going with what you want to do.
You have a new coach, Aaron Stone. He was the assistant last year. What do you feel about that, and how do you feel the chemistry and the whole organization is going to unfold?
I just think that it's a good move, and he brings a lot of culture to the team and a lot of team bonding and team togetherness, and I think we'll just end up being together and just hype each other up.
And where can we catch all these games live, Caleb?
Eztv.
You like needles?
Needles?
Come to the blood drive December 7th, 9 to 2.
So Mr. Horton has a new class next year. It's about film history. If you don't graduate this year, you should join next year.
What up, boys?
Hey,
what's up?
Long time no see.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I know.
Last year of school, you guys ready?
Kind of. I got a weird class.
Yeah, I do too.
What's yours?
Film history?
Oh, me too.
Oh, sweet.
Oh, no way.
Let's go see what this is about.
Summer went by really fast.
Yeah, I have a feeling the school year is going to be so long. So why'd you sign up for film history?
I just need an extra credit.
Do you all know who teaches the class? I think it's Miss Horton's son.
Yeah, I've never seen him before.
I don't know.
It'll be interesting. You think the class is gonna be boring?
Probably.
Yeah, film history.
We'll see.
What does that even mean? Like,
oh.
If the class is boring or it sucks, we drop out tomorrow.
100%.
Cool.
Sounds good.
Right.
Hello.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. I'm Mr. Horton.
Nice.
Welcome
to
film history.
Thank you.
All right, class. The first movie we're going to watch is Trip to the Moon. It was created in 1902.
Thank you.
man, it's crazy that people used to watch movies about color.
And sound.
Yeah, I wonder what the next 40 years of film look like.
Thumb sticking straight up in the air, just like that.
Oh, yeah, that gives me balance.
Oh, it gives you balance, does it? Ready? Aim. Fire.
How?
They won't get me. I'll go back in them hills.
You need to put...
Get up there with that lady that's up on top of this Capitol dome. That lady that stands for liberty. Take a look at this country through her eyes if you really want to see something. And you won't just see scenery. You'll see the whole parade.
I didn't think you could learn so much about just movies.
I know, it's crazy how they've evolved over the years.
If you want to learn more about film history, make sure to talk to your counselors about taking one of the classes next year.
Do you think anyone will notice my hair?
I think he's going bald.
Take it easy.